In order to better understand what Simformer Business Simulation is, let's have a closer look from the perspective of a student. When participants access Simformer Business Simulation, they have to manage all the business units that are being provided there from the start. Depending on the scenario of the game, they either will be expanding the business or developing the business in a given geographical location, as well as they either be limited to a specific set of industries or one industry, or there will be no limitation at all. When managing business units within the company, they will be responsible for all typical business processes of a given business unit. For example, in store management, all 5 P's of marketing have to be managed properly, namely store location and size, personnel, advertising, and then the trade hall, product lineup, and pricing has to be set up. In order to analyze the results, they can access the financial results, as well as review the marketing reports. We have to take into consideration the fact that all their decisions are tied up together, meaning change in one area will affect the other areas as well. If they choose to expand the business, the participants will first have to analyze the available macroeconomics into which countries they can expand. The same information should be gathered when we speak about reference regarding the products and business units. If a potential product is found or a certain product lineup is formed, which could be profitable to produce and sell, one not only has to find the market, but also find out everything about the production of the product. And afterwards, a new business can be opened. Thus, if we want to sum it up, what Simformer Business Simulation is, as we can see, it's a gamified, massively multi-user online simulated business environment. Quite a long name, but let's decipher it. Gamified meaning that majority of business operations and activities are optimized. Why? Well, A, to be more interesting and fun, and B, to be more understandable and comprehensible. Massively multi-user online means that this environment is created for a virtual economy to thrive in. And also, it's a persistent simulated business environment, meaning it works 24/7. Within the simulation, you will be facing a virtual economy, which means there is a huge amount of other participants and their decisions. The sum of all those decisions will affect the environment. It's a dynamic multiplayer. As a result, the participants within SBS have opportunity to experience economy that is built on natural human behavior. They also are required to find data to base their decisions. The participants also need to research, analyze, and improve and optimize their business. Prioritization is also quite important because the amount of resources is limited. A systemic thinking is something that is being developed over time because there is a huge amount of connections the participants have to explore, and as they find them, they have to incorporate these into their decisions. And finally, it's a business sandbox. Participants can try out a variety of different industries that might be close to something that they are working in real life, having opportunity to try out various ideas and hypotheses.